right, so this is Project Maximus, our 1968 twin turbocharged all aluminum 572 Hemi with octane on demand, twin injectors per cylinder, air conditioning, all the luxuries, but it's a wide body. So we've done all the metal working here. It's 5 inches wider than stock, but it looks subtle. We've got a 31 inch by 18 wide tire in the back, custom built rear suspension, that suspension in the front, 6 piston calipers, 14 inch rotors. I mean, it is a bad mofo, and we're really proud of it. And I'm gonna show you a lot of the little details that have been going into it. We've kind of kept it hush hush. We're gonna show you some of the before stuff going on here before we actually get this thing going. Okay, so here what we got going on is we've got the engine mocked up in the, you know, in the, some of the very beginnings here. We just finished our custom set of stainless headers, and they are just absolutely crazy because we're keeping the shock towers in this thing. So the actual clearances that we had to do to get this to work was, it was probably the single hardest header that we've ever done. And you, of course, we've got our patented symmetrical turbochargers on here. And we're running a Billet Specialties drive system, which has air conditioning, power steering, high amp alternator, all on a serpentine drive belt. And it's an all aluminum 572, you know, twin turbo Hemi that we're putting in this baby. And it's really gonna be something special. Underneath, we've got an aluminum K-frame that houses all VET suspension. So it's all C6 in the front with, 14 inch rotors, 6 piston calipers. And they're just canoes, huge calipers. And we'll just keep showing you little details about the car. So here's some showing you just some of the weld quality and the fitment quality of the pipes. You know, 321 stainless, all back purged, and just a sweet looking piece. Another deal that we got going on is I just want to kind of show you some of the clearances that we're working with in here. So here's a shot of our twin turbo headers as they're in the infancy stage of this engine bay, along with our mirror image turbos counterclockwise and clockwise, and a nice Billet Specialty true track system, all aluminum 572 Hemi. And these headers they took some serious time. Show you some of the weld quality that we got going on and fitment. Really nice set of headers. Another view of how we centered the engine. So the header on this side, it is real close. The brake master and the steering, so we had to do all custom, sorts of custom stuff like that. But you can see just the craziness of this, having to pull the header in and out, tack the tube, in and out. Okay, so I wanted to point out something special about this build over some other builds that we've done is we've actually widened the car 5 inches. It's, so the car is actually 5 inches wider. And what we did here is we had these two angles where this is straight and this is actually coming out. So we split the door and actually pie sectioned the door and kept the pie going all the way down the rear fender. This is very welded and rough beaten. So we've got some exceptional metal guys in here, and we'll show you after what the other side looks like that's actually been hand pounded to where, you know, we won't even be putting a skin coat of Bondo on it. It's really gonna be something special. But you can see how we kept on going, kept the stock filler. We've cut the wheel arc out because we've got a 31 inch tall, 18 inch wide 20 Mickey on here. So we've widened the wheel arc. We'll show you that on the other side. So this car really is a testament to what we can do with metal, because there was really nothing on this car that wasn't junk when we got it. I mean, the car was down to half frame rails, and we basically built it back up to this. There's not one panel on this car that we haven't touched or modified. So we're here on the passenger side now, where we've actually hand finished, you know, the weld and the patching. You can see, you know, how much pounding we've done and how straight it is after we've taken a 2.5-inch strip and put it all the way down. It looks like it was meant to be on this car. But the car is so big and wide that you really don't even. You barely even notice that it is a wide body, and that was the whole key, is to just be subtle about it rather than being, you know, gaudy about it. And I think that's really something, a testament to my metal guys. You can come in here with the door and see how it's spliced in on the door here and how these two angles spread apart, and you can kind of see some traces of the weld, but how it's all been panned out. Okay, so, you know, this is one of my favorite parts of the car, is how we've done the wheel arc and fit this tire in there. And you can see the Charger just eats the tire up, and it eats the wide body up, and it still looks stock. So it was just Scott Spock, the owner, made the decision to go with this monster, and I just think it absolutely fits the bill. And you can see where we've actually lengthened the wheel well and how we're patching that back in into the quarter. We obviously have got some welding and metal finishing to do still, but really coming out nice. Okay, so what I'm showing you here right here is the tail panel with the bumper. And normally when we build these cars, we like to tuck the bumpers in real tight. But since we're doing a wide body, you can see this is how much we've widened on both sides of the tail panel, the rear of the car. So we actually need to add length to the bumper and make it really tight. So we've taken two bumpers, we've sectioned them. What we're gonna do is we're gonna section and add, you know, a length of the bumper to the car on each side, basically. Another couple tricky things that we've done too is we don't wanna see the bumper bolts. You know, the bumper bolts are kind of ugly, so we've welded up the bumper bolts and then studded them from the back so we can bolt the bumper on from the back, so it'll give it a really clean look. So we've eliminated the bumper bolts here, and then we're gonna slice the bumper here, go ahead and add this piece on, tuck it in really tight to the quarters, and we're gonna get a really slick looking piece. So, again, showing off a lot of little cool metal work. You know, this is rough finished, but when we're done, you won't even be able to tell that it was been welded. All right, so we're here at the back half of the car here. As you can see, we've kind of cut out the floors. We're gonna make all new, since we widened the fenders, we've got to extend these rear pieces here. We've made some custom fuel tanks to fit into this area right here, which we'll show you. You know, all handmade, put the fuel pumps and filters inside. We went ahead and made all these frame rails, caged everything, double sheared the coilovers, water jet all these brackets, you know, basically custom made this entire rear suspension and rear frame rails to accommodate the bigger tire. Because with the bigger tire, the axle sat basically right against the frame rail. So we had to, you know, raise the frame rail so we'd have suspension travel. But we went ahead and made it fully adjustable so we can take our instant center. We've got five ways to adjust the instant center. We went ahead and had the sway bar go through the frame rail and put spherical rod bearings for the sway bar. That way we could attach the sway bar as close to the end of the rear end as possible. So it's got, you know, splined sway bars on heim joints. It's really, we've got some time into this baby, but it's a special car. Another view of the rear suspension. Some other cool things that we've done. Obviously we went ahead and made all the control arms. Again, the sway bar through the frame, being five-way adjustable on the instant center. We went ahead and water jet this cross member with some big exhaust cutouts so we can have the exhaust tucked up nice and high. This transmission tunnel, we went ahead and cut all the floor out, and then pull maxed dies, metal fin welded and metal finished them into the floor, so the transmission tunnel just sits flush with the floor rather than going ahead and just edge welding it. It's actually flanged all the way, and then as you can see, it's all clecoed in. This cage is all certified. So the roll cage is all certified for an 850 spec, so the car is legal to go 850. We've got removable door bars for when he wants to drive it on the street, but even still, we've got two sets of door bars, one straight door bar and one low one for the street. But if he ever wants to just take it off, we can unclip the door bar itself. I'll show you some of the detail work in the package tray area here that we did. All right, so I wanted to show you some of the other things. This is how we filled in the rear speaker tray, because we've got to have a steel firewall to be legal. How we fit the cage. So we went ahead and cut these panels out, pull maxed flanges, metal finished, and welded all that so the cage is just super tight to the rear speaker tray. Blocked off this piece in the back here. Again, just metal finished it all. And it just kind of shows the quality of the whole car. Is up to snuff. It's not just doing one part of the car, it's the entire car is getting details. As always, the fucking ice cream truck is still in the background. I don't know what's going on. It's at night and the damn ice cream truck is here. It's just comical that damn thing is always here. So in the wide body, we've had to section this piece here and extend it out to fit the fender itself. So we've sectioned it and you just see the cleco holes, but this will all be finished. You won't even see the seam when we're done. You can get an idea of the widening of just what the factory rocker is comparative to where the fender is right now. So we're gonna have to make new rockers to fill that in. So take a look at the size of this canoe. I mean, look at that in comparison. Six piston monster. Stop Tech makes it. It is it's a crazy looking brake, that's for sure. That should definitely slow down our little 2,000 horsepower beast when we want it to slow down. Another thing I wanted to show you about a car like this is a car like this with the motor, you know, it's making close to 2,000 horsepower or more, you have to cool a motor like this correctly, or else you're just going to end up, you know, the whole car has to be built around the motor. And that's what I'm kind of trying to show you guys is the caging and the suspension and the brakes. It's all built around the engine, so we end up building the entire car around it. So right here, it's a custom core support that we water jet out this core support, kind of nice. You know, had it all interlocked. That's where you see these stitch welds. So we water jet and interlocked it like a Lego set, basically. So we've got a 36 inch long radiator with twin 16 inch fans. We've got a really nice AC condenser, which we made a nice little custom bracket that, you know, we'll screw in. And then right here, what this is a radiator for the intercoolers. So we've got two water to air intercoolers that we're hiding underneath the fenders. And then they run through this radiator, which cools the intercooler. So you've got, you know, all of this packed into this custom core support, but the thing is gonna actually drive on the street. It's gonna be functional. It's not just a big motor scabbed in a car. It's everything is thought out on it. And there's another piece that I'm really proud of that we'll be able to graft into the car.